Today, I'm going to show you how to model some clothes for our Muggo. In the last video, we finished our blockout, but now it's time for the hat. To make the hat, I'll hit Shift A to bring up the Add menu, navigate to Mesh, then select the cylinder. I'll hit G to grab it and move it to the right of my Muggo. I'll tab into Edit mode, make sure I'm on Face Select mode, then select the bottom face, hit X to bring up the Deletion menu, and select Faces to delete it. I want to add a little fabric band around the hat, so I'll switch to Edge Select mode by hitting 2 on my keyboard, or selecting this button, then hover over the cylinder and press Ctrl R to add some loop cuts. I can change the number of loop cuts by scrolling my mouse wheel up or down after hitting Ctrl R. So I'll scroll until there are 2 loop cuts, and I'll place them where I want the fabric band to go. Then, to make the brim of the hat, I'll hover over the bottom circle of the cylinder, hold Shift and Alt together, and then left click to select the entire edge loop. Once selected, I'll hit E to extrude this edge, followed immediately by S to scale. So E, S, and move my mouse to scale, and you'll see the brim pop out. I'll switch to face select mode by hitting 3 on my keyboard, select the top face, and scale it up a little bit. Then, I'll hover near the right side of one of the faces on my fabric band, and once again hold Shift Alt and left click to select all the way around the band. I'll then hit Alt E to bring up the extrusion dialog, and select extrude faces along normals. This will extrude my selected faces evenly and directly outwards, which is exactly what I want. I'll hit 2 on my keyboard to switch to Edge Select mode, hit Ctrl R to add one more loop cut near the top of the hat, then hit S to scale it up just a little. Finally, I'll select the edge loop on the brim of the hat by hitting Shift Alt and left clicking, then I'll hit E to extrude and drag my mouse downward. If this blue line doesn't appear when you hit E to extrude, just hit Z immediately afterwards to extrude along the Z axis. There we go, now we have a hat. I'll tab into object mode, select the hat, then right click and select shade smooth by angle to smooth it out. Then I'll go to the modifiers tab and just like before, I'll add a subdivision surface with 3 levels of subdivision. Then I'll go to the materials tab and select the coat material from the material selection dropdown. I want my fabric band to have an accent color, so to add that, I'll tab into edit mode, make sure I'm on face select mode by hitting 3 on my keyboard, then use Shift Alt to select the outside and top faces of the band. In order to select the bottom faces of the band though, I'll hit 1 on my numpad to go into front orthographic view, hold Z to switch my shading to wireframe, then select all of the faces underneath the fabric band. Once selected, I'll hit H to hide them, then hold Z to switch shading back to material preview. Now I have clear access to the bottom faces of the fabric band, so I'll use Shift-Alt to select the bottom, outside, and top faces. Once selected, I'll add a new material slot with the plus button, click Assign to apply it to the selected faces, then add a new material, give it a name, and choose the color. Then I'll hit Alt-H to unhide the rest of the hat. The edge under the fabric band is a little too smooth for my liking, so I'll hit 2 on my numpad to switch to edge select mode, and then I'll hover over the brim of the hat and hit Ctrl-R to add a loop cut. I'll move the loop cut until it's nice and close to the fabric band, which will make the edge much more crisp. Nice. I'll tab back into object mode, hit 1 on my numpad to go into front orthographic view, then select the hat and hit S to scale it down a bit, followed by G to grab it and move it into position. I'll spend a little bit of time moving the hat into position using G to grab and R to rotate until it looks right. Once I'm happy with the position of the hat, I'll make sure it's selected, then hold tab to switch to sculpt mode. Then I'll hit G to select the grab brush, and I'll just nudge the hat around a little until it looks a bit more frumpled and interesting. You can change the size of the grab brush by hitting F and moving your mouse, and you can also change the strength of the brush by hitting Shift F and moving your mouse. Once I'm happy with how the hat looks, I'll tab back into object mode. Now let's give our Muggo a shirt. To do this, we're going to use the exact same process as we did for the coat. Go into edit mode, make sure you're on face select by hitting 3 on your keyboard, then make a selection that looks like a shirt between the openings in the coat. Hit Shift D to duplicate the selection, followed by escape to bring it back to its original position, then hit P to bring up the separation options and choose selected. Tab back into object mode, go to the modifiers tab and add a solidify modifier, then change the thickness to your liking. Then go to the materials tab, hit the minus button to remove the body material. You can add a new material here if you like, but I just left mine blank and white. Go back to the modifiers tab, apply the solidify modifier from the drop-down menu, and add a subdivision surface modifier with 4 levels of subdivision, and apply it from the drop-down menu. Then we'll hold tab to switch back to sculpt mode, turn on X symmetry by clicking this button up here, then hit G to select the grab brush. We want to pull the collar of the white shirt down a bit to make room for a tie to poke out of the top, and bring up the bottom just a little. To add the tie, I'll tap back into object mode and hit Shift A to bring up the add menu, navigate to mesh, then select UV sphere. To bring my sphere forward, I'll just move my viewport a little to the right, hit G followed by Y to move the sphere on the Y axis, and move it forward. I'll hit 1 on my numpad for front orthographic view, then hit S to scale down the sphere. I'll hit numpad 3 to go to right orthographic view and move the tie closer into position. To squish it flatter, I'll hit S to scale, followed by Y to scale it on the Y axis until it looks right. I'll hit 3 to go into right orthographic view, hit R to rotate the tie just a little bit, and then G to move it into position until it looks right. I'll go to the Materials tab and select the red accent material from the Material Selection dropdown. Then I'll hold Z to switch to Sculpt Mode again, make sure that X Symmetry is enabled, hit G to select the Grab Brush, then adjust the shape of the top of the tie. I'll tab back into Object Mode and right-click the tie to Shade Smooth. I'll then duplicate the tie by hitting Shift-D, followed by Z to move it downward. I'll hit Numpad 3 to go into right orthographic view, then hit S followed by Z to scale the tie vertically. There we go, the little Muggo is starting to look dapper, but now I think he needs a mustache. To add the mustache, I'll hit Shift A to bring up the add menu, navigate to mesh, and choose the cube. I'll move my camera to the right a little bit, hit G, then Y to move the cube forward. Then I'll hit Control 4 to give it 4 levels of subdivision, which I'll apply in the drop-down menu. Hit Numpad 1 to go into front ortho view, then hit S to scale the mustache down. I'll go to the Materials tab and select the coat material from the Material Selection drop-down to give him a nice brown mustache. Then I'll tab into Sculpt Mode, hit Numpad 1 for front ortho view, make sure X Symmetry is enabled, and hit G to select the Grab Brush. Then I'll push and pull the mustache around until I like the shape. Once I'm happy, I'll tab back into object mode and hit G to move the mustache into position. Next, I'd like to add a simple patch on the jacket. Using the exact same process as before, I'll go into edit mode, select the shape I want, duplicate it with Shift D followed by escape, hit P, then choose selection. You'll notice that this new duplicate inherited the subdivision surface modifier from the coat. So just add a solidify modifier and use the grip to move it to the top of the stack, then adjust the thickness to your liking. Then go to the material tab and duplicate the coat material by hitting this button here to make an editable duplicate. Let's call the material patch and just make it a tiny bit lighter than the original brown. Nice. And that's it for part 2 of making a Muggo. In the next part, we'll learn how to do some simple rendering. If you learned something from this video or you like the content, you know what to do. Also, feel free to come hang out on Discord, the link's in the description. All my love goes to my patrons without whom I could not make these videos, and a huge thanks to the Deuces Club for always sticking around to the end of my videos. If you weren't already in the Deuces Club, you are now, and if you want to join the Deuces Club members list that I pin to every video, just comment Deuces down below. Alright, that's it for today, I'll be back soon with part 2. Deuces!